CEO running for Creating Difference, doing some ball reviews, true ball reviews. Dustin's throwing the famed IQ Tour as our control ball. It is exactly sanded to 2000 grit. In addition to that, we're going to throw the new Ebonite Aero high performance ball, and we're going to compare it and see how it performs. Kind of curious to see how this ball rolls. New ball from Ebonite, made by Brunswick. Start off at third arrow. Going to use data from Specto and Clutch to be able to find out how close or far away their shots are and really be able to get a feel for the bowling balls. You can see that ball is definitely chunky. And we're throwing it right out of the box. This is the first shot with that bowling ball right from the factory. You'll be able to see the factory numbers, actually, the true scan. When we actually scan the ball for this particular piece, you'll be able to see what those numbers are. And the we use TrueCut sanding products on our IQ Tour to be able to give us a consistent, repeatable finish. And Dustin's going to throw that IQ Tour again, right around that third arrow. And we're going to take a look and see the performance difference. The reason why we're doing this is it's a good way for, if you have the control ball, the same ball we have, the IQ Tour drilled at 60 degrees by 4¾ by 30 degrees, you can get a similar understanding of if the arrow would fit in your bag. If the ball, if our control ball, the IQ Tour, hooks less than the review ball, then you should expect it to hook less for you too. It's not 100% accurate, but it's a whole lot closer than what we would do without having a control ball. This ball definitely is chunky, and this ball definitely is strong. So we're going to have Dustin throw. You gonna move? Move to the friction. He's gonna move to the friction. We're bowling on the Kegel chromium pattern. You can see the chromium pattern. And when you move to the right, we're gonna see more friction, and more friction is gonna give us a rough idea of how the ball performs when there's more hook. So we'll do the IQ Tour first over that second arrow, right around the second arrow mark. Like that. And it goes Brooklyn. And then we'll throw the new Ebonite Aero in the exact same spot and see if it goes Brooklyn or not. And like I said, it's just a comparison. That's all we're trying to do. We're not necessarily trying to strike, you're gonna get a full rack. We're not trying to strike here. What we're trying to do is we're trying to show you how the balls compare so that you can decide if it needs to go in your ball arsenal or not. In a lot of cases, that's not what you know. You're not able to know that. So we wanted to come up with a way to let you see that. That ball also went fairly close to Brooklyn, if not completely Brooklyn. Let me see what some of the Specto data says. So the Specto data says that the IQ Tour did hook a little bit more in total hook. Both those balls actually hooked earlier, and the entry angle was less on the arrow compared to the IQ Tour. So we like seeing that data. We're also going to be able to pull out Clutch and show you what Clutch shows us, which is always advantageous. So, now how was that shot, Dustin?
A little right.
That shot was right. So we will have to redo that, which is fine. No worries, no worries. No problem doing that. So we'll have him throw that shot over fourth arrow, which is more oil, right? So fourth arrow, more oil, ball's probably not gonna hook as much, which obviously it didn't. And that was slightly left of fourth arrow, but it's close enough, we can use that. Let's throw the arrow there. Now the arrow should perform well here, right? This is the spot where the arrow should perform well. This ball's definitely strong, definitely bigger hooking, and this will give you an indication of if you are looking for a ball that is a stronger piece then, and it performs more than our IQ Tour, then maybe this is a piece you should add to your bag. That's inside a little bit. So we'll have him throw that shot again. We look for a few different things with our Specto data. We can actually look at his laydown, his launch angle, And then this is kind of important, his RPM to ball speed ratio, because that helps us to know if the shot qualifies as a good shot or not. And then the rest of our metrics that we actually use are relative to how the ball performs, which is good if you're trying to get a better understanding of the performance of that ball. So we'll have him throw another shot. That looks a little bit better. So it was a little lazy when it got to the end of the pattern. Which, okay, so that just means that it's basically, it needs a lot of oil, right? That's kind of what that tells you. This ball definitely is a traction ball, just by the way it's rolling. And we're gonna, there we go, cut the lights off, get the clutch system fired up, and show you some of that data now, too, which is always good. We're gonna put a little effect too. Or throw a little effect in there so you can actually get a little bonus right here. So this is the IQ Turret third arrow. And we got a pumpkin following it down to strike. Had a pumpkin that time. And you can see the line. You can see how that ball went down the lane. Now we'll switch back to the arrow, which we've kind of already determined to be a traction ball. I'm just watching it go down the lane. So that tells me if you're needing something that's earlier rolling in your bag, that may be a piece you may want to consider. So let's throw the arrow there. Good shot, same shot. Oh, that one continued really well through the pins. That ball went really nicely through the pins. Checking out some of the data. The data actually said that particular shot, which was thrown the exact same, it actually performed slightly better, which I'd agree with that, right? You can see that as the ball went through the pins, that ball looked a lot looked better than the IQ did. So that's good. That just kind of really confirms here that what we're seeing with this particular ball is that it's a strong piece. Traction ball reaction, definitely something that you may want to add in your bag. Something first out of your bag on a heavier volume pattern. Something that definitely is different. And I think that's a really good thing, especially if you're looking for a bowling ball that's going to give you a stronger motion. So now, if you had an IQ Tour and your IQ Tour did not hook enough at your home center, then an arrow may be an option for you, because we're showing you that the arrow is an earlier, bigger hooking ball. So an arrow may be a piece you want to get. Conversely, if you're bowling with the IQ Tour drilled like our sanded 2000 grit and that ball happens to be incredibly tube strong, then you probably don't want to get an arrow. You want to get a different Ebonite bowl. So we're just letting you see a little bit about that brand new Ebonite arrow. You can get that ball, honestly, really easily too. You can get it at Bowling for Less, and you can pick up that ball there. You can also get our control ball from us, the IQ Tour, that's been sanded by CTD with a 2000 grit true cut pad, and we send you an additional true cut pad, so you have that as well. You can go to trueballreviews.com for that information, and you can pick that up from us, and we'll send it to you. And then that way you can kind of virtually join our review process, because you'll have access to the control ball that we use. So there you go. That's a good comparison between the Ebonite Arrow and the new Ebonite Arrow and the CTD official control ball, the IQ Tour. Both of that particular bowling ball, the IQ Tour, is at 2000 grit true cut. So if you like what you're seeing here, make sure you hit the like subscribe button. If you want to get an arrow, go to bowlingforless.com, pick that up. And then, as always, you got to remember, this is where you're going to be able to get those true ball reviews from trueballreviews.com. So make sure you check us out there. With that being said, I'm out here, CEO, Run It from Create a Difference. Talk to you soon. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And check out one of the other videos on the screen for more information. Thanks for joining us.